how to find comets with your hand controller. Coming up next. Hello, my name is Doug Hubble, and welcome to Astrophotography Tutorials. You may be seeing comets in the news, or other people are finding these comets, but you don't know how to find them. Well, the hand controller that you get with most mounts, they have over 40,000 objects, but they do not carry comet data in it because comet data is constantly changing from year to year, from minute to minute, from second to second. So in order to find a comet, you need to use two tools. You need to use, of course, an equatorial mount with a go-to hand controller, and you need a planetarium software, something similar to Stellarium. Stellarium is a free planetary program, and I'll show you how to use these two tools so you can enter the comet data and find it with your telescope.
Okay, so the first thing you have to do is you have to get the planetarium program so you can get your coordinates to put into the hand controller. What you'll need to do is you'll go to stellarium.org, and here you can find this planetarium program for many different operating systems. Pick your favorite flavor and download it and install it. The one thing that you'll need to do is you'll need to also enter the comet data with this other link right here. I'll put these links in the description below, but there's a special set of instructions you need to follow to enter the comet data into the planetary program. So after you have your Stellarium running and it's going for you there, you'll have something like this. If you hold your mouse over here in the lower left corner, it brings up all these options. The one thing, of course, you'll have to do right off the bat is you'll have to set the location window. You just pick your location there and make sure you have your location entered. And the next thing you'll do is, like I said, you have to enter that comet data in there by following that link that I'll list below. And then what you do is you use this date time window. Now this date time window is very handy. It'll give you ideas of, you know, when this comet will be available in your area, and you'll be able to actually see it. Then once you have that information up, just do the search window. In this particular case, I'm gonna type in Lovejoy, and it pulls it right up right there. And this is the information we're looking for. This is all the data for Comet Lovejoy. I also like to use this little target track there. But that's the exact location of where it's at the current moment. Now, all this information, you look at this and it's kind of confusing, but if you take a look right here at the RADE declination, and it's J2000, this information right here, the 9 hours, 03 minutes, 23.3 seconds, plus 2204, all this information, as you can see, it's constantly moving as the Earth rotates and as the comet is moving. So that's why it's so difficult for most hand controllers to know this data. So what you do is you find your time that you're going to start, and you then go to this information. What I like to do is I like to write it down on a piece of paper, so when I go to my hand controller, I have that information and I can enter the data in the hand controller accurately.
After I have my comet data written down on a piece of paper, it makes it easier to see at night when it's on a piece of paper too. But then the numbers that we're looking at are these two sets right here, the 9 hour and the plus 22. I'll show you how to enter this information into the hand controller next. What we need to do is we need to go to the user catalog. And the way we get there is I'm using these down arrow keys right here. And these kind of scroll up and down through the menus. So what I'll do is I'll hit that. There's utility function, guided tour, object catalog. That's what we need to get into. So there's the object catalog. We'll press the enter key. And now it goes into a submenu here, which is named star. And what we need to go to is a user catalog. There we go, user objects. So we go ahead and press enter there. Now, from here, we can do recall objects if you have a set inside there. I think this holds maybe 10 or so objects in there. But what I like to do is, I've already have one here. I'm going to say edit objects. So I use the down arrow key to get to it. And not this arrow key up here. It's the lower one down at the bottom here. And once I get to edit objects, I'm going to press enter. Now, inner coordinates. Now, what we're looking for is the RA declination. You remember when we're notes, we wrote down here, it's RADE. So that's what we're looking for, RADE. So we'll go ahead and press 1. And now it's going to ask us for the coordinates that we had entered here. So in this case, it's 9 hours, so we'll put 09, and it's going to be 03 minutes, 03, and if you noticed here in our coordinates, we have 23.4. We don't need to go that far, but we do need to take it out to one point here, which would be the 2. So we'll go to 2 right here, 2 minutes. And the next part here, this is where it can catch you sometimes. You see this plus 22? And inside the controller, it's saying plus right now. But what you may need to do is you may need to change that from a plus to a minus, just depending on where you're at. And the way you do that is you're going down here to the arrow keys and go up or down. I'll just change that to a minus, and it'll go either direction. But since we want plus inside here, we're going to go back up to here, and we want plus 2204. Then after you've done that, you've got your coordinates entered, just go ahead and press enter, and it'll ask you to save. You just go ahead and say enter save. And I'll ask you, I like to save mine on object 1. You can save it to any object number you want.
There you have your object entered for your comet, and you just press the enter key. And then the telescope magically slews to your comet. Now, isn't that great? Good luck on your comet hunting out there. If this is the first time you're watching, I would like you to subscribe. I publish 2 astrophotography videos on the 1st and 15th of every month. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you soon.